Masha and the Bear. Hello, everyone. Today, Ethan and I will give you, our story time. The story name is Masha and the Bear. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Masha. She was picking berries in the forest. She stayed on the edge of the forest so she could see her house. 就很久以前呀，有个小女孩，她的名字叫做 Masha。她每天呢都要在森林里摘各种各样的梅子，然后呢，她就一般呢，她的家就在那个森林的边上，所以她从来不敢走进森林。From the forest edge, she could see the red roof of her house. She could still see its white walls and smoking chimney. Masha's parents had told her not to go too far into the trees. Forests are easy to get lost in. Forests are hard to escape from, they warned. 然后这个她的家呢是在森林的边上。他能看见他的家呢是一个红红的房子白白的墙啊。然后呢 ,Masha 的爸爸妈妈跟他讲啊不要走进森林森林太容易丢了而且呢你也很难从森林里逃出来。这个他爸爸妈妈就一直跟 Masha 这样讲。Soon, Masha had picked all ripe fruits on the bushes so the edge of the forest.But Masha's basket was not full, and she had lots of brothers and sisters to feed. 所以就是说呢，这个 Masha 呢，摘了有一天摘了好多好多的梅子，在那个森林边上摘，但是呢，她的篮子还是很空，因为呢，就 Masha 不太高兴，因为她有很多的弟弟啊、妹妹啊，她需要就是帮她爸妈一起养。So she took a few steps further into the forest to pick more berries. Then she went a little further. Then she went even further. 所以这个 Masha 呢，就走到森林，走了一点儿，又走了一点儿，又走了一点儿，就走得越来越远了。Now her basket was full. She turned around to go home, but she could not see the red roof or the white walls of her house.She could not smell the sweet wood smoke from the chimney. Masha did not know which way to go. She was lost. 这个 Masha 呢，终于把篮子都摘满了。但是这时候她突然发现呢，自己看不见那个红房顶，还有那个白色的墙，而且呢，她也闻不到家里那种香香的木头的香味儿。所以呢，这个 Masha 呢，不知道怎么回家了，她丢了，她很害怕。Masha went left.Then she went to right. She looked all around, but she could not see the edge of the forest. She could not see her house. Masha was scared, and she was not alone. Masha 呢，往左走，往右走，然后看看周围，然后呢，但是她还是看不到森林的尽头，也看不见她的家，她很害怕呀。其实 Masha 并不是她自己，发生什么了呢？Something was watching her from behind the tree. It was a big brown bear. The bear stepped out and paddled towards Masha. He said in a gruff voice, Are you lost, little girl?
Yes, Mr. Bear, replied Masha.
Do you want to go home? Asked the bear. 这时候啊，有一只在树后躲着一只熊，这个熊在看这个 Masha。这是一只很大很大的大棕熊，这时候这个棕熊呢，也缓缓地走出来，他用很低沉的声音问：“你是不是丢了，小女孩？”玛莎就回答：“是啊，熊先生。熊”熊就问他：“你想回家吗
？”“Yes, please, Mr. Bear.”
“Then come with me.” The big bear led the little girl along a path in the forest.He led her past a few rivers, a deep lake, and a rocky hill. He led her to a cave.
我想回家呀，熊先生。那你跟我来吧。这个大熊呢，就带着个小女孩走到森林的里面啊。他们穿过了一片河，然后穿过了一片湖，又穿过了一片那个石头山，终于把她带到一个山洞里了。
Masha said.But this is a cave. This is not my home. No, laughed the bear. This is my home.
玛莎着急了，说："这不是，这是个山洞呀，这个不是我的家。"哈哈，大熊说道："这是我的家。”OK，it was cold and lonely in the forest, so Masha went into Bear's cave. She shared a basket of berries with the bear. She chatted with him about her lovely home. 这是一个很冷、很孤单的啊，这个在森林里非常冷，也很孤单。然后呢，玛莎只好进了这个大熊的山洞。她呢就把她采的那些果子呢都分给这个大熊，还跟他讲了很多关于他美丽的家的很多事儿。She told the bear about its red roof and in white walls. She talked about the smell of the sweet wood smoke, and she told him about the tasty pies she baked with fruit. Then she fell asleep. The next morning, Masha said to the bear, "Can you take me home now?" 他就跟那个大熊讲了很多他们家的事儿，比如说有红房顶啊，白色的墙啊，还跟他讲那个家里那个甜甜的木头的味道，还跟他讲他呢经常用这个水果做很甜很香的派。第二天早上，Masha 就跟这大熊说："你能不能带我回家呀？" "No," said the bear. "No, I want you to stay here and make my cave as lovely as your home." I want you to sweep the floors for me and light fires for me. I want you to cook pies for me. 不行，这个大熊说道，我想你呢留在这儿，把我的洞呢，山洞弄得跟你的家一样好。我想你帮我清扫地板呀，我想让你帮我生火呀，我还想让你帮我做很多好吃的派给我吃。He stood up and blocked the doors of the dusty cave. He crossed the big furry arms over his big furry chest. He stayed until Masha nodded. She picked up a broom and started to sweep the floor. 这个大熊呢，站在这个门口，不让他出去。他就把那个毛茸茸的胳膊插起来啊，就挡着 Masha 出门的这个路，直到 Masha 同意留下来。这时候 Masha 只好拿着一个笤帚开始扫地了。Masha missed her home. She missed her sister and fa her father and her mother. He missed her sister, even her brothers. But the bear would not let her go far from the cave, and he would never let her go home. Masha 呢，这时候其实非常非常想家，她想她爸爸，想她妈妈，想她的哥弟弟，想她的妹妹。但是呢，这个大熊是不会让她回家的。As Masha cleaned and swept and dusted and cooked, she come up with a clever plan. Masha 呢，帮大熊做了很多事儿，帮他打扫卫生啊，帮他做好吃的。这时候，Masha 有一个好主意。Instead of crying, she smiled at the bear. Instead of nagging to go home, she sing songs as she worked. Instead of mowing, she baked the best cakes and pies ever. So the bear grew very fond of her. 这个玛莎的什么好主意呢？她就是不再哭了，而是呢，她每天都对着这个大熊笑，而且呢，她也不再求着他回家了。她呢，反而就是玛莎一边唱歌一边工作，然后呢，她还给大熊做了很多很香的蛋糕、很香的派。这个时候，大熊就越来越喜欢这个玛莎了。One day, Masha waited until the bear had just eaten big apple tart. He was full and heavy. He was rubbing his fat tummy. And she said, "Dearest bear, can I ask you something?" 这时有一天啊，玛莎呢就等着这个大熊吃了一个很大的苹果派。然后呢，等大熊吃完了以后，他很高兴啊，他就摸着他毛茸茸的大肚子。这时候玛莎就说："哎呀，亲爱的大熊呀，我能问你一个问题吗？" "No," growled the bear. "No, Masha, I won't let you go home. I know that, dearest bear, I'm not asking you to go home, but my family doesn't know where I am. I came into the forest to pick up berries and for them a long time ago, and they must be worried about me." 啊，这时候玛莎就说："哎呀，不是的，大熊，我不是要回家。"我只是觉得呢，我离家太远了，我的家里人还等着我呢，他们肯定很着急。Please, can you take my family a gift from me? Masha asked. Then my family will know I'm safe and happy here with you. 玛莎就说呀："你能不能帮我给我家里捎个信儿呢？我希望他们知道我在这儿很高兴，也很安全。Next time, I will bake you a big cherry pie," Masha told the bear. "I will also bake seven little cherry pies. I will bake four for my brothers, three for my sisters. I will be so happy if you would take the little pies through the forest and leave them at the gate of my family." 玛莎说呀，下一次我要给你做一个大大的樱桃派，而且我还要做七个小的樱桃派，四个是给我弟弟的，三个是给我妹妹的。如果你能帮我把这些派送到我的家门口啊，那我就很高兴了。Then the bear wanted a happy singing Masha. He wanted her to stay and make her home a cheerful place, so he agreed. 因为大熊呢，他希望大玛莎也高兴，对吧？希望他每天都唱歌，他希望他的山洞呢，也是一个很高兴的地儿，所以他就同意了。The next morning, Masha picked a lot of red cherries from the forest outside the cave. He rolled the pastry and baked the pies. She made one enormous pie for the bear, and she made seven smaller pies for his little brothers and sisters. 这第二天早上，玛莎就弄了很多，摘了很多熟透的红樱桃，然后呢，她给大熊做了一个很大很大的一个。很香的一个樱桃派，而且又做了七个小的樱桃派。She chatted to the bear while she baked. "Now, dearest bear, I know you love cherry pies, but these little pies are not for you. They are for my brothers and sisters, so please don't sit down and nibble a cherry pie on the way to my home." 他呢就跟这个大熊嘱咐说呀："说呀，亲爱的大熊呀。"我知道你很喜欢这个樱桃派，但是这个些小的樱桃派呢是给我弟弟和妹妹的，所以请你不要吃它们哟，就你帮我送回家的路上不要吃它们。"Oh no, Marsha, I won't," said the bear. "Do you promise?" asked Marsha. "Yes, I promise," agreed the bear. "I do believe you, dearest bear, but I just want to be sure." 哎呀，玛莎不会的呀，大熊就跟玛莎保证说。玛莎说："你能发誓吗？"然后大熊说："我保证，我保证。"玛莎就说："哎呀，那我相信你的，我只是想确定一下。" When you have gone," Marsha said, "I shall climb to the top of the tallest tree. From up there, I can keep an eye on you. I can make sure that the pie get to my family safely, and I can make sure that you get back home safely." 这时候，玛莎就跟大熊说呀："当你去我家的时候呀，我会爬到一个很高的树上看着你啊。然后呢，这时候我看着你的时候呢，我要确定你把这些派都安全的送到我的家，而且呢，我也希望能安全的看到你回家。" Masha took the pie out of the oven and gave the big pie to the bear. While he was busy eating, he put four of the smallest pie into the basket around the edge. Then he stepped into the basket herself. 这时候，玛莎呢就把这个派呢从这个烤箱里拿出来，然后把那个最大的呢送给了给大熊吃。当大熊很高兴、很开心吃这个派的时候，玛莎悄悄的把这个四个小派呢放在篮子里。放在篮子边上，然后他呢，悄悄的爬进那个篮子里了。She sat down in the middle and lifted the other three pie on top of her. One pie was on her left shoulder, one pie was on her right shoulder, and the last pie was on top of her head like a hat. Masha was hidden in the basket under the pies. 这时候玛莎呢坐在中间，然后把这些派呢全都就是放在他的左肩、右肩头上各放了一个，然后呢，然后这时候呢，玛莎就藏在这些派里面了。The bear picked up the basket and began to walk through the forest. When he reached the rocky hill, he stopped. He sat down because the basket was heavy. As he rested his paws, he thought about eating another cherry pie. 这时候，这个大熊已经带着这个篮子出发了啊！他走着走着呢。就觉得很累啊， 他走过这个石头山呢，觉得很累，然后他就坐下来歇歇他的爪子。这时候他就想要吃一个这个小的樱桃派。
They smell so good, he said to himself. Does Masha really have seven brothers and sisters? Do they all need a pie?
这时候大熊就说啊，这个派闻起来好香啊。Masha 真的有七个弟弟和妹妹吗？他们真的需要这些派吗？
He put his big fairy paw into the basket to pick up the cherry pie. He wanted the cherry pie on the left.
这时候，这个大熊把他大爪子塞进篮子里，想摸摸这个樱桃派。他呢，想吃这个左边的樱桃派。
As the bear's paw curled around the cherry pie on top of Masha's left shoulder, Masha whispered.
I see you, bear. I hope you are not going to eat the pie I baked for my little sister.
当这个大熊把爪子放在这个派的时候呢，他已经摸到了这个已经快摸到 Masha 的这个肩膀了。Masha 这时候突然小声就说：“嘿，我看见你了，大熊。你千万不要吃了这个我给我小妹妹做的派哦。”
The bear quickly snatched back his paws. He said.The little girl has a sharp eye to see me from so far away. He picked up the basket and walked on. When he reached the deep lake, he stopped.
这时候大熊就赶紧把爪子缩回来了。他就说，哎呀，这个小女孩怎么这么厉害啊？那么远的都能看见我。然后他就赶紧就是拿起这个篮子啊，继续赶路，走过了湖边。这时候他又停下来了。
He sat down because the basket was heavy. He was rested his paws. He thought again about eating a cherry pie. This smells so good, he said. I don't think Masha's brothers and sisters need all these pies. Why can't they share?
这时候大熊呢又停下来了啊，他就歇歇他的爪子。他这时候又想吃一个樱桃派。然后呢，大熊就说哎呀，这个派闻起来好香啊。这个我并不觉得 Masha 的这个弟弟妹妹需要这么多派，他们可以分享呀。
He put his big fairy paw slowly into the basket and picked up a cherry pie. He wanted the cherry pie on top of Masha's right shoulder. His claw touched the pie crust.
这时候他又把这个爪子伸进这个篮子里，他摸到了 Masha 右肩上这个派了。然后呢？他已经碰到这个派的那个脆脆的那个边儿了。
Masha whispered, I see you, bear. I hope you are not going to eat the pie I baked for my littlest brother.
The bear quickly snatched back his paw. He said, The little girl has a loud voice to tell it all that way.
这时候 Masha 又小声说，我看见你了，大熊。我希望你不要把我给小弟弟的这个派吃掉哦。大熊赶紧把爪子给伸回来了，他就说，哎呀，这个小女孩怎么有这么大的声音啊，能这么远我还能听得到。
He picked up the basket and walked on. He reached the bend in the river. He stopped. He sat down because the basket was heavy. He rested his paws and he thought again about eating another cherry pie.
他只是又把这个篮子提起来了。然后接着走，走啊走，走到一个河边了，他停下来，然后呢，这个篮子他就觉得很沉很沉，他就坐下来休息。这时候他又想吃这个樱桃派了。
They smell so good, he said to himself. Perhaps not all his little brother sister like cherries. I'm sure I can have just one.
这时候大熊又把爪子越伸进去，对，就说呀，哎呀，这个派闻起来太香了。我并不觉得 Masha 的小弟弟小妹妹都喜欢吃这个樱桃呀，我可以吃一个的。
He put his furry big paw into the basket and picked up the cherry pie. He wanted the cherry pie that whopped on top of Masha's head. He hooked his claws under the pie dish.
这时候，这个你看，这个大熊又把爪子伸进篮子里。这时候，他摸到的是 Masha 头顶上那个。樱桃派，他呢？他想吃这个，他这时候他已经摸到这个装派的这个盘子了。
Masha whispered, I see you, bear. I hope you're not going to that pie I baked for the new baby. The bear quickly snatched back his paw. He said, the little girl must be up a very tall tree. 这时候 Masha 又小声说，我看见你了，大熊。我希望你不要把这个我给我们家新出生的那个小宝宝的派吃掉哦。这时候大熊突赶紧把他的爪子伸回来。他就说，哎呀，这个小女孩肯定爬了一个很高很高的树啊。The big brown bear picked up the basket and walked. He reached the edge of the forest. He stopped. He didn't like the wide open fields or the long road. He didn't like the neat house or busy people. But he was sure Masha was still watching him from the tallest tree. 这时候这个大熊呢，就拿着这个篮子走啊走。他已经走到森林的边上了，他只是停下来了。他呢很不喜欢这个很宽的路啊，然后很长很宽的路，他也不喜欢有那么多房子和那么多的人。然后呢，但是他很肯定的是，玛莎肯定还在很高的树上看着他呢。He was sure he was ready to see. I see you, bear. So he paddled out the forest. He walked up to the house with the red roof, the white walls, and long line of sweet smoke. He put the basket down at the gate. He ran back to the forest. 他呢很肯定知道啊，这玛莎肯定说，我看到你了，大熊，所以他就赶紧走出森林，到了一个红顶房子、白墙的这个房子这儿停下来，赶紧把这个篮子留在这个门口，然后赶紧跑回了森林。When he was gone, Masha climbed out of the basket and skipped into the house. Masha's mother and father got her little girl back, and Masha's brother and sisters got a cherry pie each. They all smiled, laughed, a cherry ate their pies. 这时候这个 Masha 从篮子里爬出来了，然后呢他就进了屋，他爸妈妈都很高兴啊，因为他们终于又跟 Masha 见面了，而且他的每一个弟弟妹妹们都分到了一个樱桃派啊，他们都很高兴。 And what happened to the big brown bear? He had learned to do all this his own cooking and cleaning. He had to learn how to bake his own cherry pie.啊，这时候这大熊怎么样了呀？他回到大洞山洞，发现玛莎已经不见了，他只好自己学着怎么把屋子清扫干净啊，怎么做饭呀，怎么做自己的樱桃派。好了，这个故事就是 Masha and the Bear， 这个呢是一个很有名的一个俄罗斯的一个故事，非常有意思。好啦，谢谢大家。